When I was with the Bundu boys, we toured a lot in England. We became very popular playing traditional Zimbabwean music in a progressive way. But we didn't come across many English bands playing English music, even though in other ways the sense of heritage in England seems really strong. That makes me very curious. Because every country has its own music. It's one of the things that makes a country special. So what about England? Yeah, Matt, when I look at this brilliant heritage you English people have got, how do you take it as your heritage?
Oh, well, this is it's fairly easy, this one, because you can see it and you can touch it, and it's fairly solid and it's been around a long time. But a lot of the musical heritage ain't really like that, and it needs a bit of digging around to find it.
Yeah, sure, since I'm on a voyage of discovery, very few Africans really have gone through voyages of discovery, so I'm looking forward to discover what's really happening. Because after my traveling with my former group, the Bundu boys, I've been to Scotland, I've been to Ireland, and Wales, and you find in all those different parts of these islands, all those people still have a strong attachment to their music.
I think that there's definitely an identifiable folk culture in Scotland and in Ireland and in, well, to a lesser extent in Wales, because Wales was much more efficiently colonised and put down by the English. So it's not quite as apparent. But and with the English, then it's all sort of caught up in these Victorian notions of village hall dances and Morris dancing, and you're not quite sure what's genuine and what isn't. And people row about it all the time in sort of the folk circles.
You are not going to allow the English music to die, are you?
Oh, because no. Once we've identified what it is, we'll try and keep it going.
All right.
Yeah.
Biker Hill and Walker Show. They drink bumble made from gin. Then to dance they do begin to the tune of Elsie Marley.
Probably will agree with me, Phil. Most of my historical and cultural image has been presented in such a way that it's been packaged, you know, for the tourism industry. Do you see yourself heading that way?
Well, I think that's the way that many, many Morris teams are actually perceived by, you know, ordinary people. That, I mean, through television, there's so, the famous Heineken ad.
So maybe and so if you should then take off the TF maybe in front of your face.
Well, no, that's very important. The TF, I am the fool, and traditionally the fool was the elder member of the team who...
Maybe no wonder they don't take you seriously.
Well, I think actually the public, when they see us, do take us seriously. What we find difficult is that many other teams are not taken seriously and are seen in a very sort of jokey way.
No, in fact, I must admit, after watching the show, I've been very much impressed, and this is straight out of my heart, I must agree. But at the same time, it seems not to be known out there by the young people. And if they are laughing at it and thinking it's making fun of it, then that's something to worry about.
Yeah, it certainly is, but our team has always been able to actually attract young people to the dance because, in a sense, we set it in a cultural context. We say that it comes from ordinary working people's culture. I think there's a nervousness about being English. One tends to feel that because ordinary working people's culture has been hidden and pushed to one side,
right,
we feel it's very important that we actually, that's what we're in it for.
This is three generations playing a very old tune, very Is this how the music here in Northumberland has survived? Yes,
it survived because we've managed to learn from the older generation, people like Will Taylor here and Will Atkinson. I've learned a tremendous amount. Catherine, and the other generation younger, has learned a tremendous amount. And they've kept it going. I mean, Will, why did you sort of keep playing this music throughout your younger days?
Well, simply because I was living next to good musicians. Mm-hmm. And I was the youngest one. And, I had an ambition to play like these old fiddlers.
Listening to it, it gave me my own background where I was listening to songs like Vamudara Mafeka Marengenya, Oma Unzwe Pise Mune Mari. You know, it's a very old traditional song which it has remained, it has been added, it has taken a lot of ideas from outside, all right. Looking at this traditional tune, how much has it?
It was written 200 years or so ago. It hasn't changed that much, but it will have changed a little bit. Little decorations get added, the dynamics change. And of course, as tunes move around, they move between different musicians and different areas, they change quite a bit, don't they, Will?
Would you say in Northumberland you have a musical tradition which goes back through the generations?
Oh, yes. Very strong tradition.
I mean, in Northumberland, you've even got your own instrument, the pipes.
Northumberland pipes, it's a traditional Northumberland instrument.
Okay, just think, relax, and bright. Think of those dancers in front of you. You kind of gone wrong then. And the other bit, those. It's a good da da ba dee do da. So just be careful not to race that bit. Just you and me try to get that nice staccato note on the top F sharp. Oh yeah, it's much better. See, it really lifts a bit there. That's good. So we'll do it this time normal things, twice through everything. At Folkworks, we've been trying to, first of all, let people hear this folk music, the traditional music of the northeast of England, all people, adults and youngsters. We use a lot of musicians to run these various courses, and then we also like to make sure that the younger musicians hear some of the older musicians, some of the great older musicians who are still playing.
That's good.
One of the things we like to do is to start little high school Cayley bands, and because the great thing is that after fairly short period of time, you can actually have a band that's up and running. And so we've got a lot of kids now who go to the disco one night and come to the Curlew the next night.
The roots are all still in the same sort of music as we're playing now, which is why Catherine can sit down straight away and play along with Will. She might play slightly differently, I suppose, than with the band, but it's very much out of the same stable. The energy source is the same, I think.
Okay. Catherine, how and where did you learn your music?
Well, I've been going to his house since I was about 10 and listening. But there's people in my family that play, and even before I started playing the pipes and the fiddle, I'd heard the music all my life, so it was very natural to play it. I mean, the music that I play now with the band is maybe we play some more modern tunes and use more modern treatments on some of the old tunes, but still the traditional roots are there. Even if I wanted to get away from them, which I don't, I don't think I'd be able to.
Formula One inspired engine in a car that cruises at a whispering 65 decimals. You never thought you'd find anti-lock brakes, catalytic converter, and cruise control in an executive car that takes you beyond convention.
Never say never.
The Accord 2-liter I from Honda.
It's the message for me.
It's for all of you. Oh.
Climb a aluminium ladder. Extends to 6.3 meters. $49.95 at B&Q.
B&Q. Price is so low, you just have to tell somebody.
It edges.
Only the Flymo multi-trim has a roller that guides it when it edges.
And then I just wring its neck and it trims.
A great finish starts with the Flymo multi-trim.
The edges, Jethro. Chop, chop.
Are you sitting comfortably? Then we'll begin.
Mm-hmm.
Every day, we catch 1,000 people sitting in front of their TV sets without a TV license. Still sitting comfortably?
I'll have these, what's it, done by the time you get back?
Balusters. If
you ever... I will.
Just squeeze Ronseal All-in-One onto a cloth and simply wipe on, colour and protection. Ronseal All-in-One, for a traditional hand-rubbed finish in one simple step.
Wow, that's fantastic. How did you do it so quickly?
Simple. Come on, give us your leg and I'll show you.
Ronseal brings home the beauty of wood.
Jersey, the home of Jersey Royals. Their new potatoes with the Jersey difference. And the difference is delicious. Jersey Royal new potatoes. The difference is delicious. And they're here now.
When you find out that you're doing more to protect the family car than your family's health, it's time for a new deal. Phone Norwich Union Healthcare on 0800 424242 and find out about personal healthcare.
Shop electric. Shop electric, shop Manweb. The future's looking brighter.
He's already been inside me, and he really didn't say, and I really didn't ask him, I just hoped and prayed. He's already been inside me, and I really don't feel well. I keep looking in the mirror, but it's hard to tell. Will you stay by me and take my hand and hold me till I sleep? Or will he crumble and fall to the floor and weep? Oh, feeble man. Oh, evil man. Already been inside me, would he have told me if he cared? And I know I ought to find out, but I'm much too scared. He's already been inside me, and I know it can't be good. Nothing feels the way it should. Will he hold me in his arms again and wipe away my tears? Or has he already taken my best years? Oh, evil man. Oh, feeble man.
I'm not just a political singer, I'm someone who tries to write about the whole broad spectrum of human experience, but there have been specific political issues that I felt I had to specifically write about. And because everybody else is writing about just ordinary pop stuff, people say, oh, Billy Bragg is just a political singer. And because people think that politics doesn't have any place in pop music, really, they say, oh, he's a folk singer, because in folk music, there is a political tradition that's still alive, that was never devalued like it was in pop.
No, I understand, because you have even explained a bit of my own background. Our transformation from being Rhodesians to being Zimbabweans, you know, a lot went through that whole phase. And yeah. musicians, or even artists and the like, they played their part in raising awareness towards this, I think, the whole evil of racism which was going on there. But all the same, from here, where do you see English folk music heading?
Well, I think it's very difficult to even say what is English. It's something that's definition has been lost in time. Not because we don't have a strong tradition, it's because our tradition is very much a magpie tradition. We take a lot of things from around the world because of our position in the world. So many different cultures have passed through Britain. And they don't just come and disappear, they come and the people that have brought them, whether they were the Celts or the Romans or the Huguenots or the Afro-Caribbeans, they come to our country and they stay and they are assimilated.
So the picture emerging here is an even extended version of England as being the melting pot of...
I don't like the image of melting pot because it suggests that we all have to come down to one level. I prefer the idea of a multicultural society where you recognise as you walk down the street that the country is made up of representatives of many different cultures, many different religions, many different nations. And the thing that we celebrate is that we can all exist here together and respecting each other.
Now I long for the morning that they realise brutality and unjust laws cannot defeat us. For who'll defend the workers who cannot organise, and the bosses and their lackeys out to cheat us? The union forever defending our rights. Down with the blacklegs who work us, unite with our brothers and our sisters. Together we will stand. There is power in our union.
1, 2, 3.
The union forever defending our rights. Down with the blacklegs who work us, unite with our brothers and our sisters. Together we will stand. There is power in our union.
In common with the suits in the city.
UK.
Got nothing in common with the faces on the TV.
UK.
Got nothing in common with hunting foxes.
UK.
But me mate goes mental over Chelsea.
UK. Shake of Saudi. UK.
And my sister family speak Punjabi.
UK.
UK. This is the UK talking. Oi! This is the UK talking. Oi! This is the UK talking. Oi! Alien culture.
Lyrically, because I've been born in his island and educated in a certain way, lyrically I'm certainly part of that ballad tradition of loads of words telling a story, blah blah blah. The rhythms that I use are all what I've heard around me, whether it be reggae from Brixton or Bangor from Southall, where we are now.
stay, Gudia. Oh, Bolly Bolly, now 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 stay, Gudia.
The problem is that the people aren't used to having anything other than entertainment coming at their ears when they listen to music, isn't it? I mean,
this like commercialism we are talking of now.
Yeah, they're used to perceiving life in terms of entertainment in certain formulas, whether it be like a soap opera or whether it be in terms of like a song, and it's got to deal with a certain range of emotions. And love songs have got to have a certain kind of formula around them, and don't really find anywhere you can put political songs. It's
because people tend to be fed escapism, really. And what the one thing that both your songs and traditional songs never are is escapist.
Well, a folk song is about reality.
Yes, so, yeah, you deal in realities, yeah. Not in escapist fantasies. One of the reasons I play in Rob's band is that it backs up the work that I also do for Southern Arts. In a folk development project, which is trying to make people aware not just that the old songs still exist, but that there are ways of making folk music today, that there is still very much an opportunity for people to create their own music about the lives around them. And I think Rob's music does this very much, and very much in styles that are accessible to people.
A song at the mainline station.
We must be
out of their minds, out of their sight. No final solution yet, just my imagination maybe. But nothing happens overnight. So where do we go now? With the last bus leaving for Heathrow, the piss on the stairs, the bloody tower blocks of Babylon, we're saying our prayers in an age of reason, and I know there's nothing happens overnight. In this suburban distance, but unlock your window and I'll be your moonlight. You'll be my French resistance. Nothing happens overnight. And though our lives are cheap as paper, there's something survives that burns us so bright. Father to son, no pastor, mother to daughter, no surrender. And nothing happens overnight. I call you overnight.
just takes time for you to make up your mind and to keep on saying how much brighter things will be if you are any place but here with me. What are you running from? Where are you running to? There's no silver lining in the clouds on the horizon. Hide your head up high and see it too. You say there's no place for you to stay. You say there's nothing for you to do. Sounds so sorry for yourself. Might start believing you. And your little traveling bag sits empty. But every so often I catch your eye just wandering in its direction. What are you running from? And where are you running to? There's no silver lining in the clouds on the horizon. Hide your head up high and see it.
Heather, what are your influences in your music?
Well, I suppose in as much as being a product of Devon, I'm a product of good music education. I wouldn't be playing music if I hadn't gone to schools that had good music teaching. There is a thriving tradition of folk music in Devon, but I didn't grow up as part of it.
So what brings us here?
We used to go walking on Dartmoor weekends.
Okay.
And one of my favourite places here is up over there, Houndtor. Uh-huh. And to get to Houndtor, I used to have to walk past this place behind us, Lady Jay's grave. And it used to terrify me. Mm-hmm. It used to really scare me. And I grew up not really knowing the whole story. I was given dribs and drabs of information.
So this is a real story.
This is a true story.
It's not folk.
No, this is a true story, a true piece of Devon folklore.
It sounds like even parts of Africa to me, before writing and obviously all the modern ways of keeping information came along. Otherwise, storytelling was a way of keeping our history.
Because that's the tradition that I'm interested in, telling stories that are true and creating new history. I find a lot of the traditional folk music I've come across in folk clubs very stagnant. It's almost as if since we've had recording of music being widely available, recorded versions of stories exist, and they stop changing.
So
I feel we have to keep a tradition alive by telling stories. English tradition. Crossroads, high on the moor, you will find an unmarked grave. Though it has no crumbling cross, someone always leaves flowers there. Must be the loneliest place. Told me I should keep away, but every time it drew me back, there were flowers at the grave of Kitty J. Kitty J was an orphan child and sold to a servant to a fine man a house. Master's son had an eye for a fine, pretty girl. And if a stable's not the most romantic place when you're young and rich, any place will do. If you're young and poor, how can you say no? So come to me, my pretty one. I'll lay you down in the new mown hay. There'll be no flowers in our romance. I always got my own way. Such a fine affair could never last. Such fine affairs never do. And pretty soon she was carrying his child and praying that her man would see her through.
when he shouted, screamed, called her a whore, called her a liar, slapped her face, refused to admit that he'd ever been near her. Get out and stay out, kiddie Jay. No home, no work, only the word of a serving girl against a wealthy man. That night she crept back to his fine stable, took a rope in her two hands, and loosened the rope, threw it over again, stood to climb on, to kick away, and the curse was spread in sorrow and rage for the men who always have their way. Cause suicides and criminals were not considered worthy of church ground, so they buried her at a moorland crossroads, 20 miles or more from the nearest town. And in a dream I saw her again and again, and loose in her hand as she walked away. But when I screamed, called after her, there was no answer. When I woke in my own little bed, there was a flower beside my head.
And frown now, like a good dog bit your hand all these years, and you still don't understand.
It's too late now,
English roses,
be
a sunset shires, to chase the milkmaids, to play the squire, for second chances, for a change of heart. The moors, you tell the bright young man all this can be yours. A weekend in the country, you can live out on the land all these years, and you still don't understand.
That is too late now
for your heroes,
too late now
your sunset shires,
too late now
your tunes of glory,
too late now
play it. For a change of heart, you won't be needed when this whole thing falls apart. It's time to go. You feel the cold air blow.
John, Ian, where do you see your music heading as a folk group playing rock at the same time?
I think that certainly the origins of Ian and myself are as folk musicians, you know, playing the accordion and playing the violin. But I like to think the band is now a rock band that has got folk roots, you know.
Folk roots, yes. And when I look at the whole structure of these islands, sure you have different tribal groups. How tribal do you, judging that Ian is Scots and you are English?
Well, I ought to answer that really, shouldn't I? I'm the ethnic minority in this band. We like to think of ourselves as a British band,
really?
For sure,
okay.
But then that's in response to working in other countries outside of Britain.
But are you not a bit worried that you're probably getting out of whole folk area, which still hasn't been explored as it should be, into a whole rock culture, which is very narrow?
I think the point about rock culture being narrow is a good one. I think, you know, rock journalists, rock musicians can be just as blinkered about their world and what is supposed to be rock music as the folk world is often accused of. You know, I mean, yeah, the folk world has been narrow, and it's been, that's where the cliches come from. If we can do anything to open it up, then I'd like to do it and also attract interest in.
Looks like a mile to the valley below. The next man went over and he went down slow. I lie on this bunk and listen to the rain pour. It's work to stop and start over again, and it takes a stranger to understand what the wind says in a strange land.
Just a bit worried that you need to look both ways, guys. And in the process, where do you see yourself heading? Towards rock, or taking as much as possible within the folk industry? Because within the English culture, it seems it's going to die. And are you going to be prepared to see it die just like that?
Do you want to be our manager? I think you'd be really good.
PR person, for sure.
No, yeah, I think it's, you know, the Oyster Band won't be and mustn't ever be just a pale imitation of a rock band. Every, you know, when you come from the roots that we have, you've got to keep looking back, looking at what's there, going back to the traditional, going back to the music that actually, that you still can play.
So I rode down a South Street, a woman I did meet. She asked me just to see her home. She lived on 14th Street. And away you send it, my dear Annie. All you New Yorkers, can you dance the polka? When we got on 14th Street, we stomped in on the floor. My mother and her sisters came to greet us at the door. And away you send it, my dear Annie. All you New Yorkers, can you dance the polka? When we got inside the house, drink was hand around. Liquor came so strong and quick, me head went round and round. When I woke next morning, had an aching head, found myself stark naked, all alone in bed. Me gold watch and me money and me lady friend were gone. There was I without a stitch or a cent to call me on. And away you send it, my dear Annie. Oh, you New Yorkers, can we'll be right back.
well. Over the past 25 years, Liverpool and Manchester have, of course, dominated, as in soccer, the pop scene. But Lancashire has ambitions to challenge that, and it's all tied up with the success of the Milltown Brothers from Cone. Take a look at this. The Milltown Brothers have been described as one of the best musical finds of recent years. Since their discovery 12 months ago, they've made an album, been on a nationwide tour, and soon they're off to make it big in America. Now more bands are counting on the Cone connection to lead them to the big time. And one place where their dreams may come true is this converted bike shed at Nelson and Cone College, which is now a recording studio. The experts here, though, don't just cater for rock and pop, they're equally at home with the classics.
We've got students coming now who study recording as their specialist thing, and of course we've got a lot of interest from outside groups and bands, and of course we've just done this recording with Neil Smith, the guitarist.
We're just starting to get a lot of interest really from local bands.